Previously on Halo.
So where are all the troopers?
Wasn't me. I wonder.
Where did it go?
Be advised, we have reports of Covenant suicide squads.
You've got to be kidding me.
Jared Leto!
That's a negative.
Corvette,
oh boy!
Copy 4-0.
Clear? Clear, not clear. Looks like Doom 3, honestly. That's what this picture reminds me of. Space. A frontier. Not a whole lot going on out there, I assume. I mean, there's rocks. And bigger rocks that are sometimes spherical and have atmosphere. And some big burning nuclear explosions and radiation. That's all you got up there. And big old circles, I guess. That's interesting. Hi, welcome to this. This is Halo Combat Evolved. The fucking thrusters on those are going crazy. Oh my god, you see that?
Lieutenant, all I need to know is, did we lose them?
I think we both know the answer to that.
Why am I playing this, you might ask? Well, currently I just kind of want to take a little break from Zelda at the moment. I'm still doing it, and maybe I'll do them concurrently. I just want to see if A, I can fit that into my schedule, and B, just, oh god, I'm bumping everything. This is a shit show already. Just kind of want to play something a bit more casual, a bit more fun, a bit more structured. Because open world games, like with Just Cause, they kind of suck. But Zelda, I feel like I want to do it. Anyway, so we're playing Halo, a game that I know is maybe good, maybe great. I don't know, I think it's pretty alright. Maybe that's nostalgia talking. Because they try to gussy it up with HD filters and textures and what have you, but it's still Halo. Deep down, it's still Halo 1. It's still that game that came out in 2001 that just kind of made everyone fall in love with the first-person shooter genre. That was, until then, kind of relatively niche and specifically made for the PC market. But I think Bill Gates, he's like, fucking Bungie, you guys can make this thing on this console, which is why I'm backing you as the flagship for the Xbox when it launches. And, really, I do believe we had this game to thank for the trend of first-person shooters. Whether or not you like them is, it's debatable. But I like these ones, as evidenced by the fact that I have a playlist on my YouTube channel that's just Halo with, like, 7 zeros at the end of it. So, you know, I'm into it. And I don't know if I'm going to be able to get through every single Halo game that I can. With the advent of Halo Wars, the first one getting released on Steam, as well as the top-down shooter ones being released, there is a feasible chance that I could just play every single one of them, but I never played Halo Wars, and I never played the top-down ones. I have really only played these ones. Oh, that guy fucked that up! Idiot. So in the 7 years it takes me to go through all 7 Halo first-person shooter games currently out, Halo 6 will probably be out, and that'll be interesting.
Once again, it is our job to finish what the Fly Boys started.
What did they start? It's quarter to 9 on a Wednesday afternoon. There's no one in the house. My cats are currently going fucking crazy. That's what they do when they're alone, or when they think they're alone. They just kind of chase each other around. And I'm glad they play with each other, because when we're not home, I imagine if we only had one cat, they would go insane and lonely, which is why we have two. So I'm glad they play, but at like 4 a.m. in the morning, when I wake up, because the cats are going crazy and they want food, you know? But my door is open, and I just see out of the corner of my eye every now and then, like a white streak followed by a black kind of blob of fur will just walk on by. I'm like, what the fuck?
Let's thaw him out. Okay. Bringing low-level systems online.
Oh, and it bears mentioning that I played Halo Reach a few months ago. Chronologically, Halo Reach takes place immediately before this game, so if you want any context to anything, Halo Reach isn't going to give it to you. Because that game was very much, even though it is chronologically beforehand, there's not much in the way of context of this whole thing. Because really, there's a whole bunch of story you don't get from these games. You gotta go read books. Books, people, read books. Hello, Chunderson, it's me. Chef. Oh god, look at me. How about now? So yeah, that's the thing about the, so I'm playing this on the Xbox One with the Master Chief Collection. And like in Halo 2 Anniversary, you just push the back button and bam, look at this, classic graphics. Oh my god, look at this polygon-ass polygon. When Combat Evolved Anniversary came out on the Xbox 360 in 2011? Yeah, if you hit the button to change graphics, it took about like 30 seconds to load. But luckily here it's instantaneous with the power of the Xbox One, which is, you know, a bit better, I'd say, substantially. Hello! So you know something weird? He looks like Doom 3. He looks like a real person. Doom 3, real, or like a JPEG of a real person. Isn't that weird? The lighting is great, but dude, you look better in the old graphics. Oh, great. The Easter cross.
I know the ordnance techs usually take care of your targeting sensors, but we're short of time, Chief.
Hi, Bagel! She just sprinted in full tilt. What do you want? When you lock on, you want to go sit in my hamper like usual? Oh, okay.
Okay, that looks good.
You're welcome.
I'm getting some calibration errors.
You're not. You just want to get me to switch my inversion. I don't want to. Oh, God, it's already inverted. Oh. We're just going to go ahead and try the other way. Who plays invert? Like, okay, no, I'm not going to disparage anybody for playing the video games the way that they want to play them, but inverted. Now, I will... wait, what's happening?
Okay,
we're good. What was I looking for? You can, like, you can play a game the way you want, that's fine. And if you're, like, flying in a flight simulator inversion, pretty good time. I enjoy that. What is this blue thing on my screen? Get rid of it. Oh, I have to go to the charging thing? Is this what I gotta do? You're slow. You're really slow. I'm not slow. I'm big and green. I'm a big green metal man, which I have no legs. From Halo 2 onward, they have legs. Because, you know, this is really, you know, this is, I gotta say, this is where the Halo franchise really started to go downhill. Halo 1, more like Halo done with this series. Honestly, Halo 1, Halo Combat Evolved, is a really good game that I don't think aged particularly well in the eyes of the franchise as a whole, because, and this is weirdly, like, this is weirdly specific to, not Halo 4, but Halo 5, because I played a fuck ton of Halo 5. The movement in Halo 5, taking cues from games like Titanfall and Call of Duty, adding parkour and verticality and just like fast, fluid movement through your environment. Halo 1 through, let's say, 1 through 3 are not particularly fast or fluid. Reach tried it with their sprint ability, but even then, that's the thing you can have some of the time. Oh, shit, dude, sorry. But like in those games, you could just like sprint and you could jump and, oh, by the way, don't go that way. Yeah, whoops. You can just jump, you can sprint, you can climb, you can go fast. This game, you can't really do much of any of that. And it sucks because I want to do my boost. I want to sprint. I want to climb over things. It's awful. Oh my god. Just gonna go ahead and go this way. So, everything is just kind of blown up. And I have some skulls on. Ooh, whoops. I have some skulls on that, when I tested this initially to see if this would be conducive to playing, I shouldn't have had on specifically the explosion skull, the cowbell skull that makes fucking everything blow up like whoopsies. Got him up. Get him, blow him up. Get him. That makes explosions like twice as big, and if you stand in the wrong places in this opening when everything's blowing up, you get fucking destroyed. So I turn those off. The only skull I have on currently is the grunt birthday party skull because comedy. But also, learning my lesson from Halo Reach. I'm playing on normal, just because, like, as much as I think that if I were to sit down and try, I probably could go through on even Legendary, but where's the comedy in that? Where's the funny jokes? There's a casuality to this. When I play on normal, I can take this bag of mini M&Ms, just shove the whole thing down my throat like a fucking animal.
Cortana did her best, but we never really had a chance.
A dozen superior battleships against a single Halcyon.
I just swallowed a mini M&M whole.
Sleep well?
So how do you like them apples? Oh god.
So you did miss me.
So.
Report.
M&Ms. Let me be frank with you. M&Ms suck compared to Smarties. Smarties are the superior chocolate coated in candy, but I realize Smarties are a particularly regional thing. Like, as in so regional, the only place I can find Smarties bars are South Africa. So that's crazy, but There's something about mini M&Ms. It's just the mouthfeel. When you just take the tube, you pop it open, you take a shot of this chocolate, and you love it, you love it, you love it. How? Why? I don't know. Do it. I just eat the whole thing. That's me. Getting a lot of chocolate weight lately. God, this is wordy, and you look like... I hate to say it, Keys. You look like a very butch lesbian. It's the haircut. Also, that's the model from Halo 3. That's the Cortana from Halo 3, and that's just weird. This whole game is weird. 343 is just like fucking slapdash everything together. We don't care. Budget, it's Microsoft. They're paying the bill. They're not gonna look at this. This is Halo. It's gonna sell like crazy. Don't make me look at you. Actually, oh no, you know what? He looks like Sid from Toy Story. I don't care.
Excellent work, Cortana. Thank you. Are you ready?
For doing absolutely nothing but talking.
Yank me.
What was any of that? Was she supposed to be saying something there? So the weird thing, or I guess not the weird thing, but the difference between Halo 1 and Halo 2 Anniversary is that you can view Halo 2 cutscenes as they were, but in this one, I don't have the option to view the original cutscenes like I can in gameplay. Whereas in the middle of a cutscene, you just hit that button and then boop, all of a sudden you're looking at the horrible, shitty, like, five polygons of Halo 2, and oh god, that's awful. It's weird to think that back in 2004, I thought Halo 2 was, like, the benchmark of graphical fidelity. Oh, you want to see something disgusting? You want to see something disgusting? Where is it? Where is it? Where are you? There it is! Oh, this is the worst. I hate this. I hate everything about this. This cat! This is just a meme board. Because back in 2011, memes were funny, remember? Oh, wait, why do I have bullets? He's like, I don't keep it loaded, you're gonna have to find some bullets to go. Did I walk over a dead guy? Hold on a second. No, alright. How very weird. Okay, this is good too. Now, people talk about how powerful the Halo 1 pistol is, and how they tried to make it as good as it is, and in fact, the Halo 1 pistol is so good that it exists as its own weapon in Halo 5, literally called the Halo Combat Evolved Pistol. Kill a guy in four shots or something, I don't know. It's alright. Honestly, because there's no long-range weapons and aren't the sniper rifle in this game, all you got is the pistol, and that's, you know, that's whatever. Okay, can you just fucking, I'm doing a bit here, dude. Yeah. Can I have your plasma rifle, please? Thank you. Much better weapon. Than the pistol, no, but in terms of just gunning people down... I'm using a laser gun, pew pew! And that's my favorite part of the plasma rifle. Honestly, if I had to say favorite weapon in the entirety of the Halo universe, either the Needler or the plasma rifle, which is why they make those replicas, and I'm like, damn, I'm not a material person, but I sure would love to own that. Sup, fellas? Can you get this blue off my screen, please? Thank you. That was a Star... I was gonna say Star Trek and then StarCraft, but those are not correct. That guy... like 30 seconds ago, so it's no longer relevant. He's like, did something just hit us? That was a Star... I also did it again. Star Wars reference. Get out of here. Wait, is it? I don't know if it is. I'm losing my mind. Sci-fi is the same. Okay, come on, man. Oh. Am I crazy, or if you shot those in the past, they spun?
They're using our lifeboat airlocks to attach their boarding craft. We go out and they come in.
Is it really that clever? Come on, this is boarding action 101. That's the first thing you learn in marauding school. Get it together, Cortana. Excuse me. Oh. You know, I've come to realize something, that the melee striking is definitely 100% tuned differently in Halo 1. In that, it's like Halo 2 onward, I suppose. You put a few shots at them, you melee them, they basically go down. But there's a health system in Halo 1, as you can see by the pips, the yellow pips, which is down to be blue, underneath my my shield bar. Which is unique to this one in Halo Reach, because all of these Spartans up until now did not have biofoam injectors, which is basically just your fucking medical MacGuffin that you just, like, pour on whatever. Because in Halo Reach, the Spartan 3s didn't have it, so you need health packs, and in this one, I'm still like a Gen... I think I'm Gen 1? No, I'm Gen 2. I don't know. There's a bunch of numbers to throw around. The whole thing's very confusing. I realize I'm not playing particularly carefully. Maybe it's because I am on normal and it is just a very easy game. I don't have any grenades yet. I feel like I had... Oh, I know why I had grenades. There's a skull I had on that when you hit someone, like with a melee attack, they just drop grenades. Useful. Why are you up on the wall? Oh god, he did not like any of that. They just like in Halo Reach, the elites just love to just run back and forth and fucking squirrely squid. Okay. Oh. Nice enough to supply me with some other overshields. What a bunch of putzes, am I right, fellas? Let's keep going. Flashlight time, guys. Are you ready? Oh god, I hit the button. Hello? Hey, quit shooting that guy! You don't know where he's been! Oh, he's dead. Yikes. This is embarrassing. Am I gonna run out? I am almost out of battery. An interesting thing that I don't know how much it can carry and continue on in the Halo games, but the lower you get your battery on a plasma rifle, the more it kind of misfires, as you can see just gonna happen there. That guy did not give a single... Oh, he's back. There we go. Which I think is kind of cool, because obviously as something kind of lowered in battery capacity, of course it would kind of start to weaken a little bit. I work in an industrial job. I use a cordless drill quite frequently, to the point where I'm swapping the battery out of that thing every couple days. And the feeling of putting a fresh battery into that thing, the torque it get when you're trying to like, you know, get up a, you know, like a dome nut or a screw. That's a technical jargon for you people out there, because I know what I'm talking about. The difference is staggering, because like the low battery won't even turn at all. It just keeps, you know, fighting, but you put the new battery in and all of a sudden boom bap boom, look at this, flinging plasma like nobody's regarding safety at all. There's no OSHA compliance on this entire ship. Bang. Oh right, the grand birthday party does not work in the old graphics. Bang 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 bang, you're dead. I got you. We clear? Okay, cool. A fun glitch. Oh hey, come on now, do the thing. What is happening with this guy? Die! Okay, look at this. A fun glitch of Halo Combat Evolved was that if you were to keep meleeing the corpses, blood would continuously pop out. And if you just keep doing this, an infinite amount of blood filters and layers just kind of kept falling around. To the point where it would cause the frame rate to go down like absolute shit. And I think it is kind of working a little bit. Oh, jeez. Obviously, it doesn't quite work in the new graphics. Hey, fellas, where are we going, boys? Oh, what is he saying? What's that guy saying?
The life pods are launching. We should hurry.
Should we?
The Covenant are destroying the life pods.
Huh. They don't want us on the Halo. It'd be a very short game if we didn't make it there. I'm just gonna spoil something real quick. Target nav points. I gotta say, so the reason why I keep hitting my microphone so much, oh, okay, is look at this weird thing. Huh. Huh. But then it doesn't do it this way. Huh. Huh. So the reason I keep hitting my microphone, or by extension the pop filter, is because the stand, the nice arm, the flexible arm that I used to have with this pop filter, it doesn't exist anymore, and I have no idea where it went. I think it just got thrown out one day, and that's, you know, whatever. I'll get over it, but it was mine, damn it, and I needed it. Like how my microphone stand just kind of fucking bit the bullet, which is why my microphone is currently sitting inside of a very tall box. So I have this. I made a stand out of Kinex because it was the only thing I had that could make like a relatively sturdy base. Oh, jeez. Yeah, that's right. Shoot each other. That's cool. Just keep ducking and weaving in front of each other. Oh, we're getting awfully close. Reload my thing here. There we go. That's fine. Teach you to be a jackass. I don't know where I'm going or where I'm supposed to go. At this point, it gets kind of confusing. Oh, hey, this is where my buddy died. Oh.
It looks like the Covenant wanted to catch you.
Come and get me, dummies! I don't know why they would have... Took you long enough. Oh, whoops. Okay, I definitely didn't do that. I'm pretty sure that was a triggered event. Whoopsie. Oh, Jesus. All right, not going that way. Is it you? Are you the same one? Looks like it. That was weird. Oh, man, everything is just going to shit. That could have been me. Honestly, this is bit more extreme than I would have thought. Where? Not that way. Excuse me, sir. This way, you say? I don't know about that. Maybe I'm just gonna go back this way. Maybe, no. I don't know. One of these things is a terminal I can interact with. Oh. An Easter egg. Huh. Because, ever since Halo 3, there have been little, nice little, like datapad slash terminal things you can find and read to get a lore. And this game is no different, but the difference is, it's no different, but the difference is this. You have to have the Halo app. Can I go in here? Oh, thank God. And when you go find a terminal, instead of just bringing up a screen you read in the game, it opens up the app, which is just really what I love in games, when the thing I'm doing becomes something else. Now, I could go out this door, or I could go around and have a stealth advantage. So stealth. So, what if I... I'm just trying to think of a natural, organic way to work this in the conversation because I want to talk about it, but really there is no way to say at the end slate of the videos. I'm got a new song up, and I realize in the last few videos I haven't put any link to any albums or anything in the descriptions of the videos because I think people are sick of that. As much as I would love people to buy my album, you probably get it and all. And it will return, don't worry about that, but I've realized a lot of the songs I've been using in both the outros, intros for all of my music have been specifically stuff that don't even actually appear on the albums on the album I linked. So I wonder if it would be conducive for me to link to my SoundCloud. Oh, good grenades. Check this out, frame rate. But like in the Zelda, the one that most recently went up, which was probably episode 11, I have a new song in the end slate, which is a song I just put up called You Are Feeling Dread, which is a kind of an experimental, not experimental, but it's more like an ambient electronic track, which I kind of dig, really like it. Kind of like some of the solo work I did on the Geoshred. It's nice stuff. I have a very hard time titling this is the end of the level, I guess. I have a hard time titling songs. Like, God Arranged Neo Lion King EX, or whatever that one was called. Thing What Kicks. A lot of my songs are just marathon levels. Like, Thing What Kicks and that sort of thing. You Are Feeling Dread. I've been DMing for my family lately, my brothers, my dad, my girlfriend played around this weekend, and as a DM, I like to tell people what they're feeling, which is not particularly great. They should be feeling these things on their own, but when you're not really that great a wordsmith, you gotta kind of fill in the blanks a little bit. So the phrase, you are feeling dread, I imagine like you're playing like a lo-fi horror game, and it's dark, and you're in a dark room, you can't see anything, but then like some flavor text at the bottom just comes across, says, you are feeling dread. But you don't know why? I feel like that'd be fucking scary, you know what I mean? Beer-ow-m.
Heads up, everyone, this is it. We're entering the ring's atmosphere in 5.
Really?
You sure you wouldn't rather take a seat?
We'll be fine.
See, this is the trick. Anybody who takes a seat is an idiot and not green and 7 feet tall. So I think, listen, I don't know about you, but I'm the safety inspector now. Anyway, that's the first level of Halo 1. There's only like 9 of these things, so it should be pretty easy to knock out. I feel confident that I can keep this going. This episode's only going to be 23 minutes long, so I think what we're going to do, much like the Serious Sam or the Halo Reach videos, do them one at a time. We'll see you next time. Bye!